Hey everybody, it's Nuka here. In this episode, we're going to start a Let's Play series on Medieval Dynasty. I figured I'd go ahead and do a Let's Play because I got about 150 hours or so in it. And I figured I'd share some of my tips, tricks, techniques, building style, all that good stuff. Let's see. I've changed length of the seasons to 13 days. Taxes are down to 60% because I don't like paying taxes in an imaginary world. I don't like paying them in a real world. Why would I want to pay them in an imaginary world? But no taxes means no difficulty. So 60% is fair. Build limit 200% because I want to build a kingdom. What else have I changed? I changed unlimited stamina because why? Why would I just do that to myself? And then unlimited carry weight. Also, like, it's not cheating if you still get achievements, so I don't understand why you would limit yourself. Until they, like, get carts or some sort of sled to carry logs, yeah, it seems ridiculous not to have unlimited carry weight. I mean, maybe if I could bump it up, but there's no slider for it, so it's either all or nothing. So we'll go all. I turned my inhabitants' food needs down to 50, and waters as well. And then the wood needs down to 10% because, like I said, I've got 150 hours in on, like, one world. And, yeah, I've gone through thousands and thousands and thousands of logs. So, I am not trying to waste them on firewood. Bandit's still on. HP normal. Damage normal. Poison on. Temp on. Fast crafting I turned on as well. Because, yeah, I don't get time for all that. And you still get achievements, so there's not cheating in the comments if you're already complaining. Multiplier gain by 1,000. Technology multiplier by 1,000. Dynasty reputation by 1,000. Those are all because, like I said, I've got an ongoing game way into it. And it took almost 100 hours before I hit my full XP and technology. And I think I still have a couple technologies to unlock, so. Dynasty reputation. That's just because I don't like to have to deal with it. And it seems like if you're doing a quest, it didn't really feel very rewarding before. You get like a couple sticks and like two reputation. That didn't seem very worth it. But anyways, let's get this started.
I used to have a simple life. Whatever needed doing round the farm, I'd do it. Being the eldest son, it's tough. But at least we had a living, and our plates were never empty. Then, the war came.
War never changes.
I lost everything overnight. The last thing I remember is Father pushing me away, yelling for me to run. To live. At first, I didn't know what to do. Then, I remembered. A story my mother once told me. A story about my uncle, Jordan. He made a modest fortune up north, in a peaceful valley far away from the war. For weeks, I held on to that thought. Until the valley from my mother's stories. Could see it. This is where I can start a new life.
Medieval Dynasty. I like the intro. The art is amazing. And the vibe, it's such an awesome vibe, but I don't know about that being Racimir's voice. I don't know. I just don't picture that being Racimir. He seems younger, first off, and that guy's got, like, almost a bland American accent, where I imagine Racimir has some sort of European accent. Especially since everybody's name is all European. Alright, first thing. Oh, no. Sometimes there's a cart right here when you first spawn, but not today. Alright, let's go grab some of these. I'll do a lot of the gathering off camera because nobody wants to watch all that. But I need some to get started. Stones. Oh, there's some. I need at least 5 for the axe. I will need more for a knife later. So I'm just going to grab all I can see here before I head over to Yugi's. That's another disclaimer I'm going to give you. Is I will butcher all the names in this thing if I try to pronounce them. So I may just give nicknames. Because I was planning on reading the dialogue. But if I got to stumble on unpronounceable names for me, then I probably wouldn't do that. But if I'm just going to skip and give them a nickname like I do when I read a book and I can't pronounce a person's name, so I'm not just stumbling over the name, losing my, you know, feel of the book, my vibe of the book, getting pulled out of the immersion of the book, I'll just give them a nickname so it goes smoother. I mean, maybe I could look it up, but I think the nicknames are even better. Better than calling them NPC 1, NPC 2, I suppose. So it could be, let's go talk to NPC 1 over here. I call him Yugi. Yuginost? Yeah, see? No, I'm not even bothered with the rest. I always call him Jordan for the long time. So, yeah. Okay, come on, Yugi, tell me what's up. Alright. Those eyes. I didn't think I would see them again. One blue as the sky and the other black as a lump of coal. Are you alright? You look like you've seen a ghost. That's funny. My grandmother used to describe them exactly the same way. So you aren't one. Good. For a second there, I thought I lost it. Haha. But your eyes. You look just like him. Sorry, you must have mistaken me with someone. I'm new in these parts. Just arrived at the valley, actually. My name is Racimir. I'm... Wanda's son, aren't you? Jordan's nephew? What? Did you know my mother? That one always makes me laugh. How you know my mama? Not really. I knew of her. We didn't ever actually meet. He wanted to keep his family separate. This is another thing. Families? Our families? Keep our families separate? Or his families? Because his makes it sound like he's got multiple families. But anyways, I digress. I don't think I understand. Yeah, the family's part is what I don't understand. You will. Wait, what do you mean by did? I know her. Is she well? I hope she is now, whatever there may be. I've lost both my parents in the war. Also, another disclaimer. My 100-something hours, I've barely gotten to the quest. I'm not much of a quester. I'm more of a builder. Damn it. This world. I guess it can be as cruel as beautiful. I'm sorry, my boy. Nobody should lose their loved ones at such a young age. It's okay. They died so I could live, and I plan to make the best of it. Of this life that I can in order to honor their sacrifice. Yeah, I don't really want to talk about that. I'm going to go with that one because I just want to end this dialogue. Of course, my boy, of course. I apologize. You mentioned my Uncle Jordan. I actually came here looking for him. Oh, Racimir, I hate to be the bearer of bad news. Your Uncle Jordan is no longer with us. He passed away 3 years ago. I'm sorry. I understand how you want to feel. He was a dear friend of mine. So that's it? I'm the only one left? Oh, no, that can't be. What happened? Don't you say that. Hey, look at me. This valley is filled with warm-hearted people. Who can gladly aid you with whatever you need, and I'm one of them. So what should I do now? You are free to go wherever you like and start a new life. I hereby grant you the permission of the Castellan to build and farm on any unutilized land in the valley. Construct yourself a home and see what comes next for you. You can even build a whole village if you please. There are many travelers passing through. Maybe some of them would like to join your settlement. Just like that, I can take the land free of charge? Well, you'd have to pay taxes to the king annually, but apart from that, you are free to do as you please, as long as you don't break the laws, of course, or at least don't get caught doing so. That sounds amazing. The valley looks beautiful as well. I think I'll stay here and see what fate has in store for me. I'm glad to hear that. You can find resources all over the land. Grab a few rocks and sticks from the ground and craft yourself a simple axe. With it, you can cut down trees and chop them into logs. Then you can create a wooden hammer. That will be crucial in the building process. I'm sure you'll get the hang of it.
When you build yourself a home, come back to Gustovia and talk to my wife. Yeah, there's one I can't pronounce. Deborah? She manages the tavern. Ask her to feed you. You must be famished. And then grab some beers for the both of us and come back. I'll tell you some stories about Jordan. That sounds like a plan to me. Alright. I'm not going to read these tips. I'll leave them up for a second so you can read them, but I'm not going to read them. Because I already read them. Plus, they're not, like, important to the plot. Or the immersion. They kind of actually break the immersion. Alright, let's go cut down some trees. Oh yeah, I gotta make an axe first. An axe? I wonder what these people over here, what their traits look like. Are they... Oh, he is. He is a archer hunter. Okay. Cut us some trees down. One tree. Chop a chop. Two tree. Chop a chop chop. Three tree. I also want to put the technology up so I can get the blueprints out early so I can, like, plan my village better. Because I tried one where you, like, do a normal. You get, like, stuff you might want to build your village around, like a windmill, way late in the game. And it's not like, I mean, there is a perk where you can get some of your materials back, but... You don't really get that much back. It's not like satisfactory. You're kind of encouraged to redesign. Once you get too far into a build, it's kind of permanently like that. I mean, like a real city, to be fair. We need a lot more logs than this. Lucky for you guys, I'll do most of the logging off camera. Maybe I'll leave the stump so you can see just how much logs are involved in building a village. That's something I might cut down, is how many trees I've literally got to cut down. And I've heard that they grow back, but I've yet to see it. Yeah, multiple sources have told me they grow back, but... That an urban legend, because maybe I'll leave these just to see. I've also noticed that if I have too many stumps, this texture on top of the stump glitches heavily. Like right now you can see them, but let me chop down a whole forest and they'll start glitching heavy. Alright, wooden hammer. Let's go ahead and build that. Where'd it go? Right here. I don't want the bears, I want the stone. More stones. Yes, please. Don't see any more. That leveling up thing might get annoying at first, but it'll slow down as we get closer to the harder to reach levels. I think this first episode, I'm at least going to try to get my village started and maybe pick those traits or perks or whatever they call. Skill upgrades. Yeah, I'm not going to do all this on camera. But I will be doing a lot of this just to make this village. Grab reeds while we're here. I need 32, but I'm gonna go ahead and grab extra because I don't have to come back for a while. Where I wanted to build, I think there's reeds nearby if I remember correctly. But they're a good little travel. And I'm already here. Yep, building. I got it. I think I know how to do that.
probably have more hours in the game, but sometimes the calm, chill nature of this game kind of almost tries to put me to sleep sometimes. That's part of why I like it as well. Nice and relaxing and chilled out. Also, what person doesn't dream of building their own kingdom? I played Kingdom Come, and it's cool. It's like a medieval sim, but it's missing any kind of building. That's why I've been drawn to this a lot more. There's no kind of building you can't even like. Well, as far as I played, maybe later you get like a residence that you can upgrade or something. I don't know. I haven't gotten that far. It just showed me no building to begin with, so I wasn't digging it. Because I want to build a kingdom and I want to buy a kingdom. What's fun is just buying a kingdom. I don't need a turnkey castle. I want to build mine. Oh, that's something that would be cool in this, but I would hold my breath for. Castles. Oh, I should drink some water while I'm here, actually. Things I would like to see that would be very possible. Doors on any wall besides the only one you're allowed to have them. That'd be cool. Maybe we'll put a back door on my house or something. That'd be nice. So I don't gotta walk all the way to the house just to walk in. Also, I saw that they got carts for fast travel now. Let players own those carts. Let me buy one of these things. I mean, you got the model for it. Beautiful model at that. I wonder if this lights up. So it's even better. But it's a beautiful model for a horse and carriage. You just need an animation for it so you can drive this thing. Some way for the player to sit and drive it. Yeah, just let me drive this. And then I wouldn't use the infinite carry weight, unlimited carry weight, because then I can fill this up with logs and take them home. Feel more immersive that way. That's for another story for another day. What else would I like to see? Smoke coming out of chimneys. Everyone's got a fireplace in the house. Where's all the smoke going? Gonna kill them. That, and in the middle of wintertime, it's quite atmospheric to see smoke billowing out of houses. It would make them feel more alive. It makes the whole village feel alive. I've had a giant village. At wintertime, overlooking it, you couldn't hardly tell it was full of life at all. Very few lights were on. There was no smoke coming out of any buildings. And you can't hear people talking, so there was maybe just like background ambient chatter or something from a distance. And then once you get close, it like cancels. Something like that, I don't know. Okay, let's go pick where we're gonna build. I probably need some more logs, more than likely. Never have enough stones. Never. I've never, ever been like, yep, that's enough stones. Every time I'm like, well, time to go get more stone. Let's see, where do I want to build? I was like jumping on that ledge right there. Maybe right here is a nice place to build. Ooh! How did I not see that? Oh, wrong one. F-E-F. Escape. I wish there was just a take-all button. Is there a take-all? Did I not see it? No, there's not a take-all. There should be a take-all. Grabby. Grabby that. Ooh. I think maybe tomorrow I should go exploring. See what I can find, because at the beginning, be wise to go explore. I mean, not too far off the trails to get killed by creatures in your dynasty, but note that you can find some carts or treasures, something. Get some better tools, like, right off the bat. Stones, I need them all. Treat like Pokemon. Collect them all. That should be enough for right now. I think we'll put the house right here. This is a nice place. Oh, I never equipped the hammer. Let's do that. Hammer. It's hammer time. I go ahead and equip the board. Throw my shovel on 3. Clear this out before I put it down. Let's see. Okay. Houses. Kind of want it like sideways. Maybe I'll put it back. Ooh, I wish I could get it up like that. There we go. Yeah, this would be nice. Oh, and that's another thing I would like to see added to the game is stairs. It would be awesome to be able to place stairs or ladders anywhere. Be able to maybe change this all out at once, because doing this manually sucks. Enough to change the planks of the roof yet, so. But I got a feeling I'm going to need more logs. Let me actually go get some real quick. Let's see which I could first. You guys. Go ahead and do like 3 or 4 of these guys. Trying to go around, but I guess I'll just take it down. That works too. Oh no, how many people I've actually built here at spawn? I'd never thought about it until like maybe my 34th playthrough. You know what? I kind of want to build at spawn and see what a difference it can make. I definitely remember what spawn looks like. Played a couple different playthroughs. Or at least start beginnings. Gotten to the quest where they ask you for the 1,000 logs. Once again, that'd be an opportune moment to have a cart. Like if you could fit 20 logs on it, it'd still take forever. Get that stone. Okay. Just spam it. Spam the E button. Just spamming it. These up. Because they look like crap. Unless that's the style you're going for, like a lumberyard or something. I know how to sleep, eat, and drink. Yeah, like, it'd be nice to be able to put, like, maybe a back door right here on this one, but you can't. Can you? Did I change it? Yeah, that ain't a door. That is not a door, or that is a wall. It acts like you can, but no, not really. Then again, I don't know, I've never tried to build it. It just shows in the blueprints as a wall. Maybe it just shows that it builds as a door. That'd be weird. Maybe it's a glitch. Probably doesn't work. Smacking that hammer. I might cut this out, I don't know. I'm almost done. We got like two roofs. Okay, chapters. I've reached enough chapters to where it unlocked pretty much everything, but I think there's still quests after that. Set a rabbit trap. I could do that, like, immediately. Let's go ahead and do that. So we got food coming in. Let's go get some water. Closest place for water is like right up here. Yeah, I know. That's where I'm headed right now. There's a little stream right here. Rock. Ooh, a piece of candy. 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 Drank in it. Delicious. Absolutely delicious. I can't help it. There's too many sticks all in one spot. I had to grab them. I had to turn the sound of that down. That is awfully loud. Spear. Stone knife. And hunt a wild animal. I still gotta talk to Dipper too. Never kills him. Get him right in the face. I can get that guy. The gal. Doe. Where'd the spear go? Get out with either of those guys with a spear. Luckily, I have a couple things in my inventory to eat for today. I don't even think I hit the end the second time because I don't see any blood. Let's try again. Come on, go down. Oh, that was way off. Turned right when I went to throw it. Terrible, terrible throw. It's okay, I don't need to write this one. I got 13 days during this season. 12 now. Alright, let's head back home. Yeah, that was terrible, terrible throw. Why did you try? There's a spear. Certainly looks like it. Okay, well, I guess I gotta make a new one. But I think we'll call it a night. But before we do that, let's go ahead and use these skills. We got a good amount of 5% more experience gained from extraction. I'm not super worried about experience. That's the only thing about the experience slider being all the way up, is it makes some of these skills for experience not worth it and kind of useless because you get it too fast. Axes, I will take all of these. Yes, please. You should be able to tier 2 that eventually. Okay, that's all of those. I'm gonna go with reputation points, so it's ridiculous. Oh, I got 1 on that. I've got 10 on this. That's cool. Guess we'll do these ones. Okay, now crafting. Sewing huts. Okay, and that is all. Oh, I forgot I was up there. Good thing you can't break your legs. Got anything to grab? Nope, because you gotta pay for that. I forgot. Let's eat some food before we started it. No, not that button. There we go. Inventory, please. 2 apples. And no roll. We need to find some food tomorrow. Well, that'll be good for now. Sleepy sleep. Right. Well, that's where I'm going to end this episode. I'll see you next time. Please like and subscribe and put that notification on for the next episode, because these ones I'm going to keep going. I've got this pretty good idea for a city right here. And I definitely like playing this game. Like, I had a cyberpunk playthrough. It's just too shallow. I get bored with it. Like, the shooting's fun, but it's, I can only twitch shoot so long, and then I get bored with the looter shooter. And that's pretty much what Cyberpunk is, really. It's not really an RPG game. I mean, you pick a little levels, but it's more of like an action looter shooter RPG than an RPG. Like, I wanted Skyrim with flying cars, and that's not what we got. Not saying I hate it enough, but it could have been a lot better. It should have been a lot better. I mean, it still could. I'm looking out for Cyberpunk 2, so that one might actually do some justice. You know how CD Projekt Red is with their first ones anyways. And they're not really good till about the third one, so Cyberpunk 3, that one's going to be on fire. Alright. Like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video.